in his house, and the Lord had given him rest from all his surrounding enemies. So what happened with the presence of God in his capital, he had rest from all his surrounding enemies. That's just stunning. Verse 16, your house and your kingdom shall be made sure forever before me. Your throne shall be established forever. And of course, David was the main deal. Obed-Edom was the catalyst. David couldn't have become David if Obed-Edom hadn't said, okay, be it unto me according to your word. Like Mary, come and make your home here. Okay, so, and in this time, David got a vision for discipling the whole world. Here's one of his, and here's what happened. Not only that, but his influence went to the ends of the earth. 1 Chronicles 14:17, and the fame of David went out into all lands, and the Lord brought the fear of him upon all nations. This kid was rejected by his own family. He wasn't brought to Samuel as like one of the sons. Are you sure this is all your sons? Yep, this is all my sons. Man, I don't get this. There's a son here missing. Is there a son missing? Well, there's the youngest. He's the family embarrassment. Perhaps he was illegitimate. In sin, my mother conceived me. But and so they go get him, and he's doing the work of a servant. He's with the sheep, and he's the one. This little boy out there, spending all his time alone practicing a slingshot. And he got so he could hit something at 100 meters. Got so he could, let's see if I can hit that. So when the lion came to steal the sheep, when I first read the Bible, I thought, man, he just went there and he went, rah! But I don't think so. I think he was, and then he went and got the lamb out of the jaws of the lion. And then when the bear came, there it is again. And okay. When he saw Goliath, he said, I know how to take this guy down. I did it with a lion and a bear. Anyway, but this guy, he was just trying to survive. Now he's saying His fame goes to all the earth. And all the nations are like, oh, that happened because of the presence of God in his life, in his city. Okay. 1 Kings 4. And the people of all nations came to hear the wisdom of Solomon. So all this blessing's being released in David, this worldwide influence that's never happened. And of Solomon, here's Psalm 72, may all kings fall down before him, all nations serve him. Speaking of Solomon, not God, Solomon. May all nations fall down before him and all nations serve him. May his name endure forever, his fame as long as the sun. May the people be blessed in him, all nations. And of course, Jesus said, one greater than Solomon is among you. He was releasing something. That it's actually the will of God that human beings would be so filled with the wisdom of God and have such an ability to govern with the government of heaven that all nations would come and say, show us how. Teach us your wisdom. Okay, so David, Solomon... Solomon grows up in the presence of God. He's living in his house as a little boy. He's hearing the worship in the tabernacle night and day. It's like all his dreams are like dreams of God. So as a young, still a young boy, when he goes out and God appears to him in a dream, like how did he know? Maybe he's been having dreams for a while, so God comes to him in the dream and says, what would you like? And his heart is sanctified enough, and he's been listening to his father enough that even in his dream he says, give me wisdom. And he gets wisdom in a measure that no person ever alive has experienced yet, except the one who is greater than him. And so he builds this structure. The Temple of Solomon was like 270 square meters. Wasn't very big. But it cost in today's dollars, Australian dollars, it'd be like $3 trillion. It was the most expensive per square foot structure ever built by a human being. And he has this unfathomable wealth. He's brilliant in foreign policy, commercial success, influence, innovation. He invents all these things. He writes an encyclopedia of botany and, you know, all the plants that grow in his land. And fortunately, he had a thing about wives. You know, he had a lot of wives that got him in trouble there. But he was living the manifestation. 1 Corinthians 2:9. No eye has seen, nor ear heard, nor entered the heart, or nor the heart of man imagined what God has prepared for those who love Him. And so, what God is saying is, I will give to human beings influence beyond their ability to imagine. But it comes out of this culture of His presence. There's a tidal wave coming, a tsunami coming of the glory of God that's going to go across the earth. And this wave is going to be a wave of His uncreated love. And there are people that He's preparing all around the earth that are like Obed-Edom, that they've just been hosting it in their hearts and in their meetings. And they've built the the presence of God, and they learned how it works so that you become like Obed-Edoms, you know, like, hey, we need the presence of God here. Hey, you know, would you mind, could we have a little, we just need a little time here. You know, our company's in a lot of trouble. You know what we could do? We could just like spend some time, maybe everyone who wants to could just come and we just worship God for a little bit. I don't know, you know, like there's just all these possibilities. But here's the deal. So when, fast forward, you know, 800 years or so to the day of Pentecost, 900 years to the day of Pentecost, and the Holy Spirit falls on the earth, and everything's happening, and people are being healed, and, you know, Peter and John don't have silver or gold, but such as they have, they give to this poor beggar, and they say, in the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. And he goes walking and leaping and praising God. And all of these great things are happening all over Israel. And then the Holy Spirit comes to a group of prophets who are worshiping God in Antioch and says, send Paul, Saul, he was still called Saul at that time, send Saul and Barnabas out to the nations. And so they go. And they come, and stuff starts happening in the nations, and then he comes back to tell them in Jerusalem, causes a big controversy. And I forget if it's Peter or James who stands up and says this. He says, oh, this is what's going on. This is the restoration of the tabernacle of David. And this is Acts 15:15. And with this, the words of the prophets agree. Just as it is written, after this I will return and I will rebuild the tent, the fallen tent of David, and I will rebuild its ruins and I will restore it, which means he's going to restock the shelves. He's going to restore it. He's going to rebuild it. He's going to return it. And the remnant of man, so that the remnant of mankind can seek the Lord, and that all the Gentiles, all the nations who are called by my name, says the Lord, who makes these things known of old. And so at that crucial juncture of deciding, should you know, can Gentiles enter into the household of God, or do they have to start becoming, do they need to be circumcised and keep the feasts and wear yarmulkes and the whole thing? Or could they just enter into the presence of God? And that's why they stand up and go, wait, what's going on here is the restoration of the tabernacle of David so all men can freely come to God. And is so the unconditional love of God could be accessed by every human being. So let's roll this back. Without Obed-Edom, there would have never been a tabernacle of David. Without Obed-Edom, there wouldn't have been a temple of Solomon. Without Obed-Edom, these guys in Jerusalem in AD, you know, 45 or whenever this occurred, would have never been able to reference Amos 9:11 and said that God said he would come back and rebuild the fallen tabernacle of David. So that's the end of my word for this house. Would you mind if I do this, just because this is where the sound went out? I just want to read these 10 observations that I made, because I think God is going to do something with you, Jubilee, and he's going to, you've been doing this for years, and so there have been leaders all around this nation of Australia and beyond who they've known that they keep doing that. Well, that's why they're having this problem or that problem. They keep doing it, and after a while they go, you know what? They're just blessed. They're not having any problems. They're just being blessed by the blessing of God. And all their children are getting smarter, and you know that, like the and people are getting in, they're being put into positions they're not qualified for. How did that happen? You should hear. Daryl was just telling me this amazing favor that's come upon him. So here it is. Obed-Edom, he was a Philistine from Gath. He was not qualified in any sense of heredity. Number two, he was living in the right place at the right time to receive the ark that David didn't know what to do with. Number three, he began to experience the future, the power of the age to come. Number four, he was a forerunner, experiencing the blessings of God's close presence and demonstrating the goodness of God by the blessing on him and his entire household. This demonstration was the credible witness that David needed to know it would be both safe and desirable to bring the ark into his capital city. Number five, though disqualified by natural descent, he was brought in among the Levites who staffed the tabernacle of David and later the temple of Solomon. Perhaps David brought him in along with the ark because he was the only one who had experienced living in proximity to unapproachable light. Number six, he was a gatekeeper. Number seven, he was numbered among the musicians. Number eight, over 60 of his close relatives were employed. And these might have been the guys that visited him during the 3 months that the ark was at his house. And number nine, he was blessed with 8 sons who found themselves also involved in the tabernacle. And his grandsons were blessed as well and are described as rulers and men of ability. So, Father, I thank you for Jubilee. And I thank you for this company of people that are so hungry for your presence that they just come week after week and go after your presence. I just feel like the Lord is releasing, like, they're like mantles, you know, like, I mean, I'm kind of seeing this. I'm seeing like these beautiful cloths, and they're just falling down from heaven, and they're falling on different ones of you. They're falling, and like something's falling on everybody, but like they're different. They have different purposes and different callings, and there's like this forerunner thing happening here. Father, thank you. We just receive it. We receive this blessing on this house of Obed-Edom. These are a catalytic people. And here's the, you guys are used to people having responses, so just stay focused on the Lord if you can. And the commission is to become a personal house of Obed-Edom. See, actually, Obed-Edom taught David how it works, just by example, not by, you know, he gave him lessons. Maybe he did, I don't know. But like the example of his personal culture of the presence of God in his home instructed David how to get a national breakthrough of the culture, the presence of the love of God pouring out blessing into and wisdom and favor into everything they do. So I just think the purpose of these mantles, among other things, is to give each one here a grace to go after and pursue a personal culture of the presence of unconditional love and glory, that you're crowned with glory and honor. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Why don't you stand up and lift your hands kind of around your head. The Psalm 8 where it says, what is man that you are mindful of him, the son of man that you visit him? Behold, you've made him a little lower than the Elohim, a little lower than God, a little, but you've crowned us with glory and honor. That word crowned could also be translated encircled. So now we get into the fire. There's like this swirling circle of glory and honor burning around you as you pursue his presence. And you kind of have to close your eyes and picture this, because it's actually something God's doing. God, I just pray that everyone here would become aware of the encircling, the crowning of glory and honor on their life, and that the grace that's on this house would go into the individual houses that are represented here, and that there would be such favor and grace and blessing on dreams and destinies, on children, on careers, on ministries. Father, we just thank you. Thank you, God, for a massive upgrade of influence. Influence is way more fun than ruling and reigning. Ruling and reigning is hard work. Influencing, you just are. You just are. There's an anointing on you to be influential, catalytic in every environment, to bring the blessing of God into situations. Yep. Thank you, Father. You just, there, it's coming. It's coming. It's coming. So what I'd like you to do is just stand there. Would you take the hand of the person next to you on either side? If there's someone on both sides, just one. If there's only one on one side, it's fine. God, we thank you, Father, that it's always been your desire to find a people with whom you could dwell. This is your purpose. That there would be, you guys, you've been doing this for years, you know. It's not like it's a whole new thing, but there's going to be a whole new level of your grace to carry this presence. And when you all gather together, when you come in, it's going to be like you can't wait to get here, so that the glory, the bright glory cloud, all your little glory circles, the crown with glory and honor, all that glory and all that honor is going to just go into one huge swirling cloud of glory and honor that's going to release the atmosphere of heaven into your lives, into your dreams, and it's going to be a witness for the city of Sydney, for the major influence centers of Australia and the Pacific. It's going to spread into Asia. It's going to jump across to India and even to the east coast of Africa. It's going to go around the world. This is the great Southland of the Holy Spirit,
And God is going to burn with unquenchable fire. Jesus, do it, God, do it. Whoa, 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 whoa. More glory, more glory, more glory. Shh. Amen.